Hey everyone, John Sonmez from simpleprogrammer.com, and I've got a actual interview on this channel. I don't think I've done any interviews on this channel, but I'm probably going to start doing this. One of the main reasons why I wanted to do this interview was because I heard from Taiseer Joudeh, who's here with me, and he has created a very, very successful blog in a pretty short amount of time. And he is using a lot of the things that I always talk about that you should do with creating a blog. So he's a real good example. So I wanted to interview Taiseer and just ask him about how he, you know, got into blogging, how he basically was able to grow his blog so much. So so welcome and thanks for doing this interview.
Thank you, John, for inviting me for this interview. I'm an avid reader for your Simple Programmer, and to be honest, a lot of your blog posts left a positive impact on me, so thanks for giving me this opportunity.
Yeah, no, I'm glad. I'm very excited, you know, to have you here. And maybe let's start with a little bit of background about yourself. One of the things that really impressed me is you're from Jordan, so a lot of people are going to relate because a lot of people say, well, I can't do this because I'm not in the U.S., but here you are with a very successful blog, and you're in Jordan.
Yes, thank you. Well, my name is Taiseer Joudeh. I am currently living in Jordan, Amman, and I work as IT manager at Aramex. It's a logistics and courier company. I have like more than 8 years experience in software industry, ranging from ASP.NET stack and other open platforms. And recently I've been awarded with the Microsoft Most Valuable Professional Award for ASP.NET IIS. Once I started blogging, really, I didn't think about this award, but it comes naturally. You produce good content for the community and it comes naturally. So the internet for everyone. So you should not be in US or Europe to do something like this. If you believe in something and have passion in something, you can just start and go and produce content and reach anyone who is interested in this area. Yeah.
Right. Okay. And just to give a little bit of background, how big is your blog? How many views do you get on your blog per month, per day, like?
Recently, like from around 3 months ago, I started to receive more than 100,000 page views, which is around 45,000 unique visitors. And per day, it ranges between, you know, Sundays, Mondays, and the beginning of week in US, I got the most of views. It's usually more than 4,500 page views. So it started gradually, and I shared my stats on my blog post. It started gradually. Once you produce a content and you add value to this content, people will start share your article, and they will build the credibility, and they come to you and read your articles and share them. Yeah.
Right. Exactly. Yeah. That's really impressive. I mean, just like that's about what Simple Programmer is doing now. You know, so that's like it's about the same size, which is pretty impressive considering you started a lot later than I did.
Thank you.
Let's talk about where is your blog, just so people that are listening and watching can go and check out your blog.
Well, my blog is bitoftech.net, bitoftech.net. I'm the only person responsible for this blog, and all the ideas and posts is contribution for me only. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I like that domain name, bitoftech.net. That's really easy to remember.
It was hard to pick a domain name, but it turned out it's a nice one, and people like it. Yeah, it's easy to remember.
Yeah, easy to remember is definitely a good thing. So what actually got you started then with blogging?
Well, it's interesting points. A bit of tech is like 1 year and 3 months, not that old. But I guess there are two main reasons that pushed me to start blogging. I'm a strong believer of the quote saying, if you want to master something, then you need to teach it. Yeah. Almost like 1 year ago, as I told you, I was in the phase of learning how to build single page application using frameworks such as AngularJS and how to build backend services. using ASP.NET Web API. In this period, I really learned a lot, and I read a lot of posts, I read a lot of technical articles, watched a lot of video tutorials. I gained a lot of knowledge. So I felt I need to maybe to share and express my ideas with the community and put myself with the community. I learned from blog posts, so I am sure there's others who contribute to this and put a great amount of their own time to just to teach the community. So I felt that the easiest way to start is to write a blog and start blogging. And I believe this is why the main motivation for me to start the blogging journey. The second reason, I always wanted to have to build a name and a good reputation in the software industry. So I believe the simplest way to get started is to start a blog and maintain it. I always wanted to have a central base on the web for me that I will express my ideas, share my knowledge with the community. And I think it will be good if someone Googled your name and found useful content on the internet that you written by you, right?
Oh yeah, yeah, definitely. Yeah. Yeah, I totally agree with your points too. I think a lot of people that maybe are considering creating a blog, but they don't know if they can grow it, or one real good reason to do it just because whether you think it can go anywhere is, it's like you said, the best way to learn something is to teach it. And so, you know, this is a good avenue. And then what you're right on about building a name, like when someone Googles your name and then they find your blog and they start reading that blog, all of a sudden it's like you just got a 3-hour interview instead of a before you've even gone into the interview, because they're reading your stuff, they know
exactly
that you're serious.
And it opens really, once you have a good blog, it opens a lot of opportunities for you. So it's a good thing, and a good thing to do in software industry especially.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, so it sounds like you kind of start out with the mindset of obviously of teaching, but you wanted to build a name for yourself. That's part of the reason why you created the blog, which is good, because you're able to apply that strategy from the beginning. So how did you apply that? Like, how did you actually grow this blog? Because I mean, when did you start your blog?
I remember it was my first real post was in November 2013. So it was 1 year and 2 months ago.
Wow. That's it. Yeah. So in 1 year and 2 months, you're able to grow it up to the size it is now, which is really quite huge. So how did you do this? Because most people, I mean, this is faster growth than I was able to get. This is faster growth than most people. So what was your method for success here?
The method or strategy? It's an interesting question. Well, I think there are many factors that helped me gaining good number of visitors in short duration, and I will share those factors for you. Before you start blogging, it is always better to be focused and find a niche area to talk and blog about it. People, by doing this, people will remember you easily, and your post will be focused on this niche area of technology. In my case, I didn't come and take ASP.NET technology stack and go and cover everything in ASP.NET. No, I focused on a very small niche, which is ASP.NET Web API. I want to learn how to build RESTful services. And that time the framework was still new and there was not that much content on the internet about it. So after a while, maybe after 5 months of blogging about ASP.NET Web API, I always wanted to find a good resource for how to secure ASP.NET Web API, how to do the REST authentication, what's the right way to do this. So I found myself using a smaller niche within the ASP.NET Web API, and I am now blogging about open authentication, how to do Web API authentication, and how to do authorization. And this focus niche really helped me to build a wide base audience. I really receive a lot of emails and comments asking me about stuff related to ASP.NET Web API security. So basically, when I started, as I told you, there was a very minimal number of posts of tutorials on the internet covering this part of technology.
Right.
And as well, I remember that I was looking on queries on Google Webmaster Tools. There is a lot of keywords looking for Web API authentication, Web API security, something related to tokens, authorization, which was not covered truly on the internet. So I assumed that people want more about this, and I decided to build a tutorial about ASP.NET Web API security. And I started and found out that I am writing 10 detailed posts. Some of those posts really received more than 500 comments, which an indication how engaged the readers are. Yeah,
that parallels, and I'm glad you said this, because this is, and as your number one point, because this is something that I really stress, especially in my blogging course, as I say that you need to specialize. And a lot of people say, oh, no, I want to write about ASP.NET MVC, because I'm an ASP.NET person, or I want to write about this and this and this, and I try to tell them, no. I know it seems like that's the right thing to do, but you want to be the big fish in the small pond. You don't want to be the small fish in the big pond.
And that's
I'm glad you said that, because this is something that, like, I keep on preaching it, and people are like,
yes, you have to focus on something. It's fine if you want to write about something else, as long as you have bigger audience. But if you are starting, I think you need to focus on something, blog about it, people will know you about this thing. Then
exactly.
You can, from there, you can start and write about something else, or explore new technology or anything else. Yeah, this is one factor.
Yeah,
I guess there is another factor that played a good role in building large number of audience, that I really always strive to provide post with high value content.
Yeah.
I guess my style of writing focuses on quality and deep level of details, not on how quantity I produce. Audience really always looking for detailed content in the post, and they are looking for value in these posts. They are looking for something to help them doing their job in a better way, or something that will teach them a new skill or concept. Sometimes I notice there is a short blog post, like 500 words, 1,000, but there is nothing new on it. So that's why maybe you do not attract visitors or attract views. But really, if you are providing a good level of detail, you provide value, then I'm sure that people will like what you really write.
Yeah, that's a really good point. I think a lot of people can write kind of shallow posts, but it looks like you've tackled hard topics that people didn't want to touch, that were difficult to explain. I mean, I know, you know, personally, web API security, I don't even want to, it's so difficult. Like, I don't, you know, a lot of people have said, I'll teach web API, but I don't want to try and figure out the OAuth thing, and it's hard to explain. And, but you've, because so many people have not done that, because you took the time and went and did that, there's a huge value there. You're filling in that. It's a lot of extra work for you, I'm sure, but there's a reward for that, because it's something that most people aren't willing to do.
That's right. I felt there is a gap about maybe web API security. There is like well-known people talking about, but there is a gap. If you watch like a Pluralsight course, no one is touching web API security.
Yeah.
They are just doing a nice application and doing very simple authentication maybe. So I wanted to tackle this one. At the beginning it was hard, but post by post and everything, it turned out that it was very useful for the community. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
One thing as well as a factor maybe that grow the visitor for the blog is I tend to break down the big topics to smaller chunks.
Yeah.
Web API security is something huge, but I build like smaller parts. Each post is like 2,000. Maybe 3,000 words. Still, it's big, but I guess people like to read like parts, not just a very huge post in a single post. Maybe you do like a part one, then you do part two, then you do part three, and this. And by the way, like audience that they are really waiting and willing when you are going to post the next part of your blog.
Yeah. That makes sense too. That'll increase your page views too, because then people would continue on. Like maybe they Google search and they find the first part, and then they go to the second and third. So you get, which
exactly.
Is a good thing, because Google likes it when you have people staying on your site for longer, right? The more page views, you know, it gets tracked through Google Analytics and stuff when you have that installed. And the more that you get click-throughs, the better it is for you, because that means people are engaged.
That's true. I agree with you. And the last factor, and I consider this one is the most important, and it's a golden rule for me. If you want to write a blog post, write it because you feel the passion about writing. Not you feel because it's like a work or a task that you have finished it. You have to blog because you like blogging and you want to help people out there and you want to express and share ideas. As well, write and really never expect anything in return, especially if you are new to blogging. People might not know you before and you need to build the credibility and reputation. So I guess by following this rule, you will have a good follower base in a short amount of time. Really, don't expect anything and write with a passion and love for what you do. You will build a good audience and people will start to know your name.
Yeah, I like that. I like that. That's a good approach to take. I think a lot of people too, it's like they want immediate return and it takes some time. You got to be consistent, right? And then eventually, if you do this, you will be successful.
It takes time, and you have to be patient and wait. But if you have passion for this thing, you will not get bored of it, I'm sure. Yeah.
Yeah. Now, do you ever hit a point where you don't know what to write about or you don't feel like writing? And then what do you do?
Yes, sometimes I feel sometimes that I don't want to write or something like this, but. Really, once you feel that you have people like your post and they are willing to share it and learn from it, this is a great motivation for you to write. And if you feel that you are dry or write or out of post, you need maybe to learn something new, read more, buy a book and read more inside this book. Maybe an idea will come to your mind and you start a new tutorial or start new series of posts. So once you learn more, I am sure that you will able to produce more and contribute more to the community. Yeah.
That's a really good point. Yeah. I find that when I'm stuck, if I read something or even if I have a discussion with someone about something technical, then I'm passionate about it. All of a sudden, I have all these ideas that come from my mind, right? When you have, especially if you get in an argument with someone about something, and then now you can write it all down. But that's a good point. Okay.
That's right. Yeah.
So what tips would you give, like, for someone who's starting out? You know, how can they best, you know, what kind of things are going to help them the most in creating a blog, maintain that blog, getting the most out of it?
Okay, once I started, really, I felt that the main obstacle. Once you start, that it's hard to bring visitors to your blog, especially if you are starting from nothing, you don't have any contribution to open source project, or you don't have any name there out on the internet. It's really hard. So I asked myself at the beginning some negative questions, such as, for whom am I writing? Am I wasting my time for nothing? Will my content be interesting to someone? They will make fun of me, you know, these negative questions.
Right.
But really, I followed some tips that other successful bloggers already followed and shared, and really it turned out to be successful. You need to tackle this one like step by step, and I am sure that you will be able to build a good number of audience in short amount of time. So I kept a list of this, and I will share this with you one by one.
Okay.
First of all, and we have talked about this, you should have a passion, really. If you have a passion for the thing you are doing and the thing you want to talk about, you will write a nice blog post. You will write a detailed blog post that people like to share and people will value what you are producing, because you are providing them a content and providing them a value. Otherwise, if you are, as I told you, if you are doing it as a work, you will get bored very easily and you will quit blogging very soon. Maybe you'll do 1, 2, 3 posts and that's it.
Exactly. Yeah.
The second one is really try to express the complex topic in a simple way and use your own words and style of writing. Don't pretend that you are someone else, and always be generous when you provide the information. There is nothing wrong about saying that you don't know this point or this area in the blog post, and I am sure that someone with better expertise in your area will come and read your post and drop you a comment answering this question. It happened a lot of times with me.
Yeah.
Another factor or another trick, you have to be consistent, especially at the beginning. Yeah, this is very crucial and very important. Do not like blog 3 posts, then disappear for like 3 months, then come and blog another 2 posts. This really will not work. network, and people will not will forget you. And it's hard for you to build a brand if you are not consistent, especially at the beginning. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Totally agree with that. Yeah.
As well, it's really fine to share your post with websites with higher ranking and larger audience. It's fine to try and do a guest posts. For me, I break down large tutorials for smaller parts, okay, and shared some of them on like Encode Project. Encode Project have a nice feature called Technical Blog Feed feature, where you can post in your blog, and the same content goes to Code Project have a huge number of audience, so they will come eventually to your blog, and you start people start know your start know you through your blog. So that's fine to write in places where you have better audiences.
Okay.
As well for yeah.
I was going to ask you a question about that because a lot of people ask about this. So if I understand correctly, you're taking the same blog post that you wrote on your blog and you're putting on Code Project as well. Because a lot of people say, well, wait, I can't duplicate the content, or I want to have me be the source. I don't want someone else to have it. But what do you say to that when people say that?
Well, there's nice thing, I don't know if you know went before, in Code Project there is something called Technical Blog Feed,
yeah,
where you, like, if you put your RSS feed at Code Project website and you put a category like Code Project, once you blog post, they will pull this content and put them in their website. But they directly mention that the original content exists on your blog post.
Right.
So for me, it really was great at the beginning. You can't imagine how much page views and referrals I got just from Code Project. There's a huge number of audience. They come directly and continue the other posts, especially if you are doing like multi-part posts. They will you put like number one and two, and then 3, 4, 5, you keep them at your own blog, and they will continue and go to your blog. So it's nice strategy. Yeah, it's nice strategy to build page views and bring visitors from Code Project to your website. Yeah,
that's a great one. I'm taking notes on that one. I'm going to start doing that one. That's a good tip.
It's interesting. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. What else? Yeah. If you are writing tutorials like me or technical articles, try to do two things. I find out that those two things really people like to find in any technical article. First thing, put your code on GitHub or Bitbucket. Okay, put the complete source code that they can download it. Just do build or just run it and it will be working. Okay, and not just put like a snapshot of the sample codes in the blog itself. No, put a link for the complete source code on GitHub. As well, if you can, it will be great if you put like a working demo of your tutorial on the on the internet. People tend to like to view demos and open them and play with them before try to implement them. So as much as I can, I try to put like a working demo of the tutorial I am doing, so people can know what they are going to implement.
Okay, that's a really good tip. I think a lot of people don't go that far, right? They just put a little snippet. And then so, but if you get known for being someone who has the full code available, who has these demos, then someone's more likely to come back because they know they're going to get good information.
And you build a good name on GitHub as well.
Yeah.
The number of stars, the number of forks, and everything. It's really interesting. And it's part of providing a value in your content.
Yeah.
It shows that you really, really care about what you produce. You're putting a source code. You are hosting some tutorial live, and you are maybe paying for this hosting. So it really shows the value that you are producing. And people appreciate this. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Appreciate this. Another tip, I find this tip is very important for anyone who started blogging. You need to be kind and friendly and patient with anyone who leaving you a comment or dropping you an email. If you are writing quality content, really expect you will receive a huge number of comments and emails, and you should reply and engage with them. The reader who left you a comment is the reader who really read your post to the end. And this reader really will follow your blog feed. So respect him, reply him, answer his concerns, answer his question, and engage with the people. Took the time to read your post and took the time to drop you a comment. You will be amazed on how much those comments will add value to the blog itself. This type of discussion really get interesting and will motivate other readers to engage with your content and drop a comment, because they will eventually know that you're going to answer them and get back to their concerns. So you have to engage. I know it takes time. I spare like 1 hour each day to maybe answer comments. Maybe some comments I don't have answer for it right now, so I go and do a Google and research just to answer this one. But people value this. I am sure the guy who I answered him will follow my blog feed and he will be a loyal reader for my blog. So that's important thing.
Yeah, that's a really good point. That's something that I think I'm probably going to regret saying this on air, but you know, I answer just about all the emails that I get. Right. And people are sometimes amazed. They're like, wow, I mean, you must get a lot of emails. But it's so important, because that's how you build fans that actually really care about, you know, I say from going from cold to hot, you build those hot fans that really consume what you want and have a good connection by following up and doing those things. And it's hard. I mean, it takes time, but it's worth it, because you build a real community, and it's you know, people like to connect with someone who's real, who cares about them.
Exactly,
not just
I totally
trying to,
agree with yeah. you. And you will get surprised. Sometimes people who are subscribed to the comments will start replying and answering other people's on the comments section, not you. So people like to discuss and do this stuff. But yes, you have to. You are the blog owner, and you produce this content. So you have to engage with the readers. Exactly.
Yeah. Good point.
Another important tip is using social media in the right way. For me, I find, to be honest, I don't have Facebook page or something like this for my bit of tech, and I don't think Facebook is a good place to share content. But Twitter is the right platform to do this.
Yeah.
And if you don't have big number of followers, use hashtags. I know people, there's a lot of people, and I am one of them, that usually check this web API hashtag, ASP.NET, ASP.NET MVC, Angular, JS, this stuff. So with hashtags, I am sure that people, if you produce a good content, people will see your post, and you will get the chance that someone with like 10,000 followers to retweet your post, retweet your tweet, and that's it. It will go viral by time. And for me, I sometimes tweet the same tweet multiple times a day, because you know it's a different time zones.
Yeah. Good point. Yeah, I don't use hashtags nearly enough, because I try to hit the different social medias, but yeah, I should definitely start doing that more. And I definitely tweet multiple times, which is something that a lot of people don't realize is important, because they just
it's important think, because yeah. Sometimes you tweet in the morning, people in the US will be sleeping, and I mean at my time zone, and it's vice versa. If you tweet at night, no one be interested in maybe in Europe or in my region. So you have to like tweet it multiple times in different time zones. Exactly.
Yeah, and people aren't going to get upset at you for doing it. I mean, if you tweet like 20 times, then maybe they will, but.
Yes, don't spam them. Yeah,
yeah.
3-4 times, that's fine.
Yeah.
But not more than this. Yeah. As well, when you write a post, think of the basics of SEO.
Yeah.
Write a friendly SEO posts, search engine optimized posts. Just like focus about the keywords that you want to cover in your blog post. Write friendly URLs and include these keywords in the URL and the title of the post and the meta description. I think those the main the basic parts that you need to focus once you write a post, because eventually after time the number one page views generator will be Google or whatever Bing, search engines in general will drive page views and visitors to your blog. Yeah, so
exactly.
Take care once you write especially the title and the URL for your post, and include the right keywords. That will be very good for the search engine.
And for the people that they, I mean, a lot of people are probably confused about SEO. They think it's this, really difficult thing. But you use WordPress, right?
That's correct.
And
I use
so,
WordPress.
do you use like a Yoast SEO plugin, right?
Perfect. This was the last point I want to talk about, but I'm using a very simple plugin, which is Yoast. Okay, this is the people who do self-hosting, and it turned out it's very simple. You just need to focus on the content, use the right keywords, and leave the search engine for WordPress and focus on your content and how you use the keywords and the titles, and with the help of this plugin, you will be in good shape. Yeah.
And it gives you a score so you can see like how, if you're
Exactly.
green
How
or yellow or red
yellow?
on
How
the.
good is your post? Yeah. Exactly. The last tip that I want to talk about is really do not waste a lot of time to create the perfect website with UI and the best user experience in the world. Just focus on what you love to do, is writing posts and sharing knowledge. Once I started Bit of Tech, I started very I don't know anything about blogging and the blog engines and everything. So I went to the simplest way and used WordPress.com. It was hosted using WordPress. I used like a free template, and once I felt that I am building like a good audience and there is a visitors coming to website, I take the courage to do the extra hard step, which is hosting it on WordPress, self-hosting it and using WordPress.org. I felt that I need to have more control on my website. But there is one recommendation. It's very important that buy your domain from the beginning. Okay, do not exactly do not depend on the subdomain that comes with WordPress or a blog post or any other blogging platform. Buy your domain. So once you need to move to another platform or want to move from WordPress.com to WordPress.org, this will be easy step and will not lose any page ranking or any search engine results. So basically, that's it. That's the tips that I can remember, and I would like to share with you and with the viewers.
Yeah, that's very good. Yeah, thanks. That's a lot of good things in there that I think a lot of people don't realize. These are all a lot of the. I was very glad to see that you were or to hear that you're talking about a lot of the things that I keep on harping on. So now it's not just me saying it. You're saying it, and you've got a successful blog. You've been more successful than I have because you've grown your blog in 1 year to the size that it took me 5 or 6 years. So,
Thank
but
you.
you know, by doing these tips, which is really good. So,
Exactly.
bitoftech.net, right? Yeah, see, I remember it because it's such a good domain name, and people could go out there and check out your blog. Appreciate you doing this interview. What can I, or is there anything that you want to promote, or you want people to visit, or anything? That maybe you're doing a talk or anything like that you want to talk about or.
Well, for now, there is nothing coming to my mind, but I really enjoyed speaking with you, and I hopefully this video will motivate someone to start blogging. I'm sure there are a lot of smart people out there that they need just maybe to take this step and start blogging and sharing their knowledge with the community, and I'm sure they'll be successful. It's an easy thing if you tackle it one by one, and I'm sure many others will benefit from this.
Yeah, thank you. All right, awesome. All
Thank
right,
you.
best of luck with your blog. I can't wait to see it hit 1 million page views a month.
Sure. Hopefully. It takes. Yeah, it will take time and take. But I hope. I hope. Yeah.
Hey, well, I hope you enjoyed that interview with Taiseer. He's a great guy. Really was glad to have him on this channel here and to have him do that interview. He's been really successful with his blog in a very short period of time. There's a lot to learn from him, myself included. I did want to let you know real quick about an opportunity that I have that's totally free that can help you get started with creating a blog. If you're watching this video and you're interested in creating a blog and seeing some of the success that Taiseer has had with his blog, I've had with my blog, you might want to go to DevCareer.com. careerboost.com/blog-course. And I'll put the link here so that you can see that and click that. But it's a free 3-week course that I'm doing, that it's an email course. You sign up and you'll get 2 emails a week for 3 weeks that will walk you step by step on creating a blog and being successful with that blog. So check it out if you're interested in creating your own blog. You know, anyone can do it. It's really not that hard. I make it really easy in that course. All right. Well, I'll talk to you again next time. If you like this video, if you'd like to hear more tips about improving your career as a software developer, software engineer, tech professional, whatever you might be into, just subscribe to this channel. I'd appreciate it. Take care.